Did you see the video of him walking away from a fight?
Yes.
You knew it was not true because you know that he fights in the street. It was you. Where's Duarte and him in Tijuana getting in a street fight? But he got very famous without even trying. He's motivated. You say twice he walked away from a fight, huh? You don't walk away from fights. That's not you.
I'm right here.
November 30th is the date. I'm going to be there. Hey, who came in the fancy limo out there? I thought some big movie stars here.
There's... I have the keys in my...
Oh, you did? Oh, that's it. You go viral. Now you're famous, huh?
Buffalo.
So Chino, how are you feeling? Good.
Good.
Who are you going to spar today?
I'm going to start again. Hold on. I'll start again.
Leo, right there, he's sparring Chino. You going to take it easy on him today?
Leo's going to take it easy on him.
Leo.
Let's go see what Chop Chop's up to.
What's up, Eddie?
I'm good. How you feeling?
Very good. I feel good.
Who'd you just spar?
I'm feeling better and better. I sparred Mark Castro and then Anthony Cuba.
Now how'd it go?
Good. Good work.
Yeah.
They got different styles, you know, hard to get used to. So it's good, you know, for the experience.
There's Anthony right there. We had a good time. You lost like 10 pounds of sweat right there. That's good. You're working.
Yeah, hell yeah, we're working.
There you go.
Getting ready, December 7th,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Hey. Oscar Duarte about to head out to Saudi Arabia any day now. What day are you leaving? Do you know? Oscar, what day are you leaving?
The next week.
Next week?
Tuesday.
Zurdo's already there.
Yeah?
Yeah, Zurdo left yesterday.
Yeah.
You're like Alexander Usyk. I see him do that. Yeah? Complete fighter. By the way, yesterday, Canelo Alvarez, 19 years professional. Yes, yesterday. A lot of years. Superstar. He's working, but you're ready. You're ready to, right now to fight tonight.
I'm ready. I'm happy. I'm very focused. And I'm happy. Enjoy the work.
Working very hard. One of the biggest punchers in boxing. Oscar Duarte, future world champion here. Anthony Cuba, another future world champion in the house. Just sparred Chop Chop. Did you go easy on Chop Chop today?
No, we don't do no easy work.
Hey, do you see how disrespectful Ring Magazine were?
No, what happened?
They did a list of the top 140 pounders in the world.
Oh, and guess what? They got Devin Haney number two.
They got Ryo, who's the champion.
And 10.
That's disrespectful. Yeah, why even put him on the list then?
I don't know.
That's stupid.
It's like... I don't know, bro.
He's a champion. He has to be 1, 2, 3, or 4,
yeah,
period.
Yeah, for sure. He's a champion, like you said.
Sorry.
He's world champion. I don't know, bro. I feel like at this point, it's just all politics, you know?
Yeah,
it's
but
not
it's...
what you know, who you know.
He beat Pitbull, who was ranked like 3 or 2 in their division. And then they have people who lost, people who moved up. They have all kinds of...
Yeah. It doesn't make no sense, bro.
He beats most of the 99% of those people on the list.
Yeah, for sure he does.
And they didn't put Ryan Garcia, which is very funny to me too.
Yeah, exactly.
How you feeling, Carlos?
Louis, I just sat back recording.
Reporting.
Hell yeah.
What are you working on now? The bag?
Nah, right now I'm gonna try to see if I can fix my head because it's new, so I'm still trying to find the right spot. Cause it feels good at first, then I start sweating and it starts going everywhere. So I'm gonna try to see if I can adjust it to where it fits perfect, you know.
That's crazy, huh?
So is there's Kawachi in Mexico. He's undefeated. Do you know who he is?
No, I don't know who he is.
You know Kawachi?
Talking
a lie. Let's see. Introduce yourself to the people.
Hey,
Kawachi. is this guy is a very rich businessman. You know Kawachi? You know Kawachi? You don't know Kawachi? The guy in Mexico. He implanted biceps. He implanted chest. And he fights professional. Hey. You know Kawachi? El boxeo. Tell him. Tell him. Tell him who he is.
Un güey de México que...
Undefeated.
But
he has fake muscles. They're implants. But I'm saying he's undefeated too. Yeah, but that's what my point is. Being undefeated doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, no. No, I was a joke.
I know. But they put him as number two.
That was ridiculous.
Ring Magazine were very disrespectful towards Ryu. They made a list of the top 10 140s, and they put Ryu, who's the champion, who beat Isaac Cruz, is number 10. That's unacceptable. And they put Josh Taylor in there, who moves up to 47. They put Devin Haney, who's not even top 100 in the world at 140. They put all kinds of people in there. They didn't put even Ryan Garcia. You know Ryan. They should have put Ryan in there.
I'm not saying Haney's a bad fighter. No, he's a great fighter.
No, I am.
But you know what I mean? After Ryan's performance like that, and they put him number 10 and Haney number 2, I think that's sort of ridiculous. I think those spots should be switched.
So Chop Chop's fixing his headgear right now. The better?
Yeah, way better. It's because when I put it on at first, it was good, but then once I start sparring and I start sweating, then it starts going everywhere, you know? They barely hear me and that shit goes this way and I can't see and it gets frustrating, you know? So I had to fix it right now.
All right, well, it's fixed.
Yeah, so.
I know you always wear your cup 24/7, wherever you go, you're always ready. Now you're gonna wear your headgear all the time.
And now we're gonna train with the headgear.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you a funny Kobe Bryant story. So Kobe Bryant told me, and it's true, I have a video, he loved to ride motorcycles. Because when he's in a car, people recognize him and they drive everywhere.
Okay,
so I said, Kobe, I got a solution for you. Why don't you drive a car with the same helmet?
You told Kobe Bryant.
Yes, he said, Ellie, you're a fucking idiot.
Hey, Ellie, but, is Instagram live?
Yeah, no, YouTube live.
YouTube live? Instagram live, man.
They're not feeling you today?
They not, bro. Okay. The Instagram live was cracking last time, though. Oh, wait,
that was YouTube.
It was YouTube live?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
We gotta
get wet a little bit. Let it cook.
I gotta share it in my other things, and then it's gonna shoot up. Hold on.
Okay, yep.
Lindolfo, the Ring Magazine were very disrespectful to Ryu.
Why?
They did a list of the top 140 in the world, and they put him number 10. He's a champion because they're idiots. If I knew, I would tell you.
Ryan's a beast and a good boxer.
And a champion.
Yeah, and a champion.
They put Josh Taylor in there. I don't think Josh Taylor's a 140. They put Devin Haney number 2.
He beat the most feared boxer, right?
Correct.
Well, one of the most fearful boxer, Pitbull. Yeah. Chingol Rayo, bien fácil.
That's just stupid boxing stuff. It's showing the floor right now. Oh, there we go. Now. But Lindolfo, he's fighting December 7th. Lindolfo, 21-0, what are you? 20, very soon, 22-0.
Yes.
And you're fighting December 7th in Arizona. Who wins, Duarte or Navarrete, the rematch?
Who
wins, Oscar Valdez? Or Navarrete.
I was
thinking that Duarte should get the winner, but yeah. He's too big.
I like both boxers. I'm 50-50. Okay. I always support, since I was little, Oscar Valdez.
Now
Navarrete is a good boxer, so.
Canelo celebrated yesterday 19 years as a professional. When is the first time you met him?
It was in San Diego in one of my fights. But I know Canelo is a huge boxing fan.
Yes, he is.
That's why he's still there. And
he trains like he never won a fight.
Yes, that's right.
Not a champion, a fight. He's worth hundreds of millions. So you're sparring next?
Hey, you're ready. Well, welcome back.
Look who just walked in the gym today. Look who's here. How you feeling, Pita? The Yankees won.
Hey, Yankees are 7.
Are you betting any money?
Nah,
they want to know how you feel about Carmel.
Very talented, future boxing. Hey, Yankees in 7?
Hell yeah.
Are you betting money on it?
There you go, Ellie.
Okay, we're going to go back. I will. Yankees in 7?
Hell yeah.
Pita, how happy were you yesterday when they won?
Pumped up,
why did they win? Because the fans stole the balls from the guy's
best
head?
In the world, that's
why. But they struggled.
Huh?
Hey, Big G's in a great mood since his birthday. How you feeling? Working, working, working.
I was picking up my car.
What do you got? Which one?
Toyota Grand Highlander. I got a new car.
Yeah, you need bigger a bigger car. One. Yeah. Welcome to welcome to the club.
Yeah.
You need a lot of space, a lot of room. At a baby's born yet?
Nah, any day now.
You and Chop Chop. I think you'll have to open up a daycare near the gym.
Yeah, we will.
We will soon. Oh, yeah. A lot of kids. Who would you trust to run it?
Would I trust, out of all the pros, like who would I trust to run the daycare? Shit, nobody. None of these guys.
No, Jose Ramirez. He's pretty responsible. No, what about the coaches? Can Felipe run a daycare?
Felipe has his own daycare. He's got like seven kids.
So he's experienced. Yeah, that's good. He's got his own daycare. That goes good in a resume. Yeah.